Now, quickly, this is what you can do on a Sabbath. First of all, be prepared for the Sabbath, especially in during the times of year where the Sabbath starts early and you're not going to have time to prepare everything when you come home from work that evening if you're not already off work. So prepare up to then and minimize your stress going into the Sabbath. He doesn't want us coming into the Sabbath stressed and unfocused. Then we can't focus on Him and heavenly things. So be prepared that way. Now, on the Sabbath, if you don't have others you can worship with, then you can do it in your own little gathering. And if that's just your family, it's just your family. Remember, the Father says, what? Wherever two or three may be, where's He? He's right there in the midst. So this notion of we have to be in these congregations of people, in these church buildings, aren't true. What did the disciples do? They were going to homes and all these other different places. Man started these churches and what are we looking at now? Cathedrals and stadiums. Come on. How many people are getting a true message and how many people are getting a show of entertainment? We have to pull ourselves away from that and get into an environment where we can focus. Now, the hope should always be that if along the way, as you progress, you can find others to worship with and you can get together and come together like that. Small gatherings or what have you, that works for the Father. He would rather have two or three as opposed to 10,000 dealing with a show of entertainment. Now, also, this is what you come together on the Sabbath, you do all heavenly and spiritual things. You can sing, you study, you can worship. Here's a very important thing that we do. We do nature walks. We take the children out, the little babies. They love to do nature walks. They know more about nature than most adults out here. And they learn to appreciate these things and they love it. We have to pull ourselves away from the world and teach our children the things of heaven and the things that the Father has done, or they will not recognize it or acknowledge it as most people don't. So we do nature walks, we study. Now, we don't watch TV in it's in that sense. Now, what you can also do is study and watch spiritual movies. And I'm not talking just any type of quote-unquote spiritual movies. We watch movies that are about scripture. There are a couple of great collections out there that are very focused and a lot of its accuracy with scripture. But we use these as a guide to help keep the children focused and keep them busy from time to time. And they're great learning tools. Our grandchildren, they know more about Moses and Abraham and Joseph and countless others than a lot of adults out there, and I can guarantee you that. They know who the Father is. They love Him. They know when the Sabbath starts. They know when it ends. They know what they're not supposed to do. They're very disciplined in that regard. And as they grow, they will stay disciplined, and they will keep loving the Father. And with that, we do those types of things. You rest. You read. You study. And you go through the Sabbath day just doing all spiritual things. There's no shopping. There's no going to malls. There's no movie theaters. There's no restaurants. There's no financial transactions of any sort. This is a sanctified and holy day. So understand if it's not of a spiritual or heavenly nature, that's what we're not supposed to be doing. We're supposed to be focused on Him. So simply, on the Sabbath, we're supposed to do heavenly and spiritual things. There are lots of things that we do, but primarily it's about focusing on Him, studying. As you see with my wife and I, we do videos to teach. So in I guess in an indirect sense, we're teaching others on the Sabbath, and we're just doing whatever we believe His will to be, to help enlighten others, to help bring others forward to the message and the truth. So it's something you go into with true faith and belief, and always be prepared to let Him fight the fight for you, because it's totally contrary to what we're taught and what we believe. So there are going to be some issues. Turn off your telephones, all these types of things. The enemy will always try and work on the Sabbath to get you to break the Sabbath. So you have to work hard to create that environment of sanctification, that holy environment on the Sabbath day, and stay true to the Father. And you will see it grow, and you will see it flourish in terms of what a blessing this day truly is. It's a day truly of rest and focus in Him, heaven, and creation. And when it's all said and done, you go into every week totally refreshed spiritually, physically, and you grow to look forward and love the Sabbath, because you have allowed Him through the Holy Spirit to create this day as an untouchable day for you. And it becomes your shelter, and you look forward to it. It's a wonderful thing. So there's just so much more and so many different angles and issues to cover in it. But on the surface, that kind of streamlines it in some regard. So just keep that in mind. And if you have more questions, just ask. And I'll do the best I can to answer them. So with that in mind, remember, the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful. This is 2 of 8, 7. I'm out.